Well, it's calving season finally. Been waiting for this for the last 3 weeks. And we had a calf born yesterday. I didn't get any video yesterday because, well, just too busy with the calf, and I had to run to the Sioux for an appointment, and it was Jess's birthday, so by the time we did all that stuff, I just didn't have time to do any videoing. But you can see we've had quite a bit of rain the last week. So this morning I went out and put a bunch of new bedding down for the cows, and I fed one bale, and then I'll feed them again Friday. But anyway, we got the calf over there in the pen, and the calf was actually born just on the edge of the bedding there, but then it stumbled into a puddle, and so when we found it yesterday morning, it was laying in a puddle, and it was freezing rain, so we ended up taking it inside. Its mouth was a little bit cold, and so we washed it all up, which made it turn colors because it looked like a dark red, but it was just from all the clay. So, and it turned out to be a relatively creamy colored calf. So it's a little heifer calf. So if anybody's looking for a nice heifer, we'll be selling her this fall. Mom is a Charlet Limo, and the bull is pure Charlet. The mother was polled, and the father's polled, so good genes. Tyrese, our bull, is bred to be a small calver, so, and he did his job so far. She had it unassisted yesterday, so. Anyway, I'm going to try and get this rope off of her, and then today's the day for mama and baby to be free. So get the rope off of her, and then we'll let them out with the other cows there. And we got a few more that are looking pretty close, so. Anyway, yeah. So calving season starts. Well, we're down here by the creek. We walked from the house, followed the creek over to the 10, because we are missing a duck.
A duck.
A duck, eh? Mm-hmm. Got your stick? And nothing on this side. Now this side is the one that doesn't really have many trees or brush on it. It's the other side that has more, so here, stay out of the water. So it doesn't look like it's dead. I was kind of looking along the banks on both sides, and I didn't see a dead duck, because I was thinking maybe a mink came along or something and killed it. But I don't see any feathers or a body, so I guess that's a good sign. I'm kind of wondering if maybe she's got a nest on the other side of the creek, up underneath the treetop or something. So we'll have to walk the other side and see if the dog can't scare her up. But I see some fresh chew over there, some fresh beaver chew, so I'll have to keep an eye on that. Last year we lost quite a few poplar trees because the beavers came through, and I didn't notice until it was kind of too late and they had taken down a couple dozen trees. But no, You're not going to drink out of a puddle. No. So, yeah, we're going to walk the other side. Get up off the ground, you conehead. And, yeah, see if we can't see it. And the calf is still in that pen. The cow went out, but the calf is still laying down in the bedding in the pen. So, and I don't want to force her out of there. So once she gets out naturally, we'll close that pen up just so that it stays a little bit drier and the bedding stays nice. And then if we need it again, well, it's ready to go. So anyway, that's what's going on. Just heading down to the barn. It's Thursday. So, yeah, the calf that we had born on Tuesday is now just over 48 hours old. And she's doing good. Mama's doing good. And we're just waiting on more calves. Last couple nights I've been getting up at 2:30 to go down and check the herd and make sure that everything's still good. And we haven't had any more calves. There's a few of them that are definitely... definitely getting close. But, yeah. So we're still just waiting. Hey, Tyrese. Oh, Mama's getting a drink. You can see the calf there by the feeder. Sleeping. But yeah, there's two or three out there that are very, very close to calving, so keep an eye on them. A bit of a frosty morning. It's froze pretty good last night. I think it got down to around -4. I put out fresh bedding and a little more hay for them yesterday. Went for a walk back in the pasture yesterday, and it's coming up pretty good. Starting to get a green tinge to her. So right now we got, we got 4 litters of rabbits that were born over the weekend. And then we got, what do we got? I think we got, so we got 6 due early next week, so we'll probably be putting nest boxes in this weekend. I'm hoping for probably around 75 babies, I would hope, but that's if most of them have litters. So got some new baby chicks over there. Going to be getting rid of the black sex lynx. Turkeys are doing good. And Mama Turkey is up on her nest. I think she's been setting for about a week. So hopefully she ends up hatching some eggs. Got a few wieners still to sell. Two of them are sold. And then that leaves us with half a dozen more to sell. But yeah, the rabbits are doing good. Other than that, not a whole lot. We're just waiting for calves. We ordered a 3-ton of fertilizer for the hay fields. That should be coming in next week. Yeah, getting that time of year. So anyway, hopefully we have some calves. Supposed to be a nice day today. Supposed to be up in the high 50s and clear and sunny. So I'd imagine in the sun she'll probably be reaching 20 degrees. And good day for calving. So hopefully today's her. Alrighty, guys. So it's now 10 o'clock in the morning. And we got Smokers, who is definitely starting to calve. We were hoping to get her up into the top pen there, but the feet are there. So, got the calf out. Both mom and calf are doing good. Everything went pretty smooth. So now we're just helping drying it off and put some clean bedding around it. But everything's good. So this is calf number two. There's calf number one laying in the sun, sleeping.
Yeah, kids one and two.
Yeah, and then our kids, one and two. Oh, the good old farm life. So we're back to barnyard number one. Went to feed hay today, and the frost let go in that barnyard. And dropped the front axle of the tractor down a couple feet and had to drop the bale where it was and then get out of there. So I rolled the feeders into this barnyard by hand and ended up feeding in here. The frost is still in this this little plateau here, which is good for the moment, but I just don't know how long it'll last of being solid. But for now it's good, so Worst case scenario is this ends up getting soft and we have to maybe move them back into the other barnyard there if it dries out. Or throw them, yeah. There's lots of options. So, this is the last calf that was born. There's your mom there. His mom, sorry. So, he's about 36 hours old. And we're going to tag, bag, and vaccinate. So, lucky day, little buddy. Not really, but anyway, other than that, everybody seems to be doing pretty good. We were checking over some of the cows there today, and there are definitely about three of them that are looking like the next day or so. So anyway, we're supposed to get a pile of rain starting around 3 o'clock tonight, and then it's supposed to last for right through late Monday. So yeah, it's supposed to be the worst tomorrow, which is Saturday. It's supposed to be the worst. And then Sunday, easing up a little bit, but still just cloudy and wet. And then Monday, not real nice either. But so I was glad to get everything fed today. This should last some 5 days, which should get us in the clear of the storm and then start drying out again. So anyway, we're going to get at the calf here and get them all straightened up. Lively little fella. Not bad for having a quiet herd, though. I mean, this is his mom here, and other than doing a little bit of groaning, she's not too upset, so. It's nice having a quiet, quiet herd. So, what's that? So, anybody interested in him as a bull, speak now, forever hold your peace. It's gonna be too late. Anyway, I was saying to Jess, I feel bad just videoing while she does this, but. Well, she's used to me just videoing while she does the veterinary stuff. So, he's going to go from being a bull to being a steer. Yeah. So, we always try and band our bulls within 48 hours of them being born. That way you don't have to go through the whole rigmarole of castrating later. What's that? Get a view of that? Get a view of his
knockers.
Look at the size of them. Anyway, those will be dried up and shriveled up.
Before he even knows it.
Yep. A little easier doing it like this than dealing with a 1,000-pound bull. There we go, number 7. Tagged and bagged. Let me pass that needle to you there. And then this is just the shot of selenium. And is it muscle or? Yeah, in the muscle. So shot of selenium, because in our area it's there's a lack of selenium in the ground. So, yeah. And then normally we dip the navel, but we haven't on the last two calves. Just because we're lazy. So this is me. Here. I'm supporting this hay feeder. Just making sure it doesn't go anywhere. But, yeah. So anyway, there we go. It's done. I guess we should maybe get the shipping tags in them, eh?
They'll be fine.
We got to run them through the head gate anyway.
Yeah,
Taz wax them. Yeah, that's right. So, probably just end. Yeah. That's nothing to throw a tag in their ear. Hey? Not like trying to reach in underneath them when they're.
Get my head
kicked off? Yeah. Anyway, nice little sunset.
Can I get on the back one now? Go for a ride.
Go for a ride? No. Anyway, that concludes today's story. I'll be back up tonight at 2:30 for my circle check. Come down here and make sure all these women are tickety-boo. You guys have heard me say this before. The unfortunate part of this barnyard is that we have the creek right below the hill. Which we've lost a calf in before. I was born in the night, and when we came out the next morning, we found it down in the creek, but it happens. Last summer, we put some posts in, and there is barbed wire across the bottom now, but it goes across the water on this end and at that end, so the cows can still drink. But it does stop the calves from getting in the area where it's really a steep bank, right there. Right there, they could easily get out. Down here, not so much, which makes me a little bit nervous since, you know, the bedding is right here. And all it has to do is stumble down, and I mean, it's a fairly steep drop right there, and I don't think it'd be a good end result, but. Hopefully by coming out in the middle of the night and checking on everything, that between that and, well, maybe having some good luck, maybe they'll stay up here. We did get the implement shed part of it ready today for a calving pen where we store some of the square bales. And so that's all ready to go. So that... and we actually have a pen in the barn too, so if tonight, by chance, if it's pouring rain and we got somebody that's looking like calving, we can just throw them into the pen. And or tomorrow or whenever, if it's nasty out, we can get them in out of the weather and have maybe a better birth. So anyway, with that note, watch out behind you there. We'll close that up. That's not the friendliest cow. Anyway. Alrighty.